Good evening, Chairman Brown, Board of Education members, and Superintendent Simmons, audience. Music in Our Schools Month began as a single statewide advocacy day in celebration in New York in 1973 and grew over the decades to become a month-long nationwide celebration of school music in 1985. The state of Georgia has formally acknowledged Music in Our Schools Month for the last 38 years. The purpose of Music in Our Schools Month is to celebrate and engage music educators, students, and communities from around the country in promoting the benefits of high-quality music education programs in schools. An example of that is our Griffin High School Concert Band. They are under the direction of Daniel Goodman. Mr. Goodman has been a music educator for 12 years, and he has spent three of those here at Griffin High School. When Mr. Goodman came to Griffin High School, there were 20 students in the program, and we're proud to say at this time there are now 80 students in the Griffin High School Band. Last week, Griffin High School Concert Band attended large group performance evaluation, and if you're not familiar with that, it's a state annual assessment of school performing groups. When the students are there, there are three songs that are performed, and they are adjudicated by three professional musicians. The scores range from one, which is a superior, it's the best you can receive, two is excellent, three is good, four is fair, five is poor. I am proud to say that Griffin High School received a superior and two excellent in their performance and an excellent in their sight reading as well. So please give them a hand. Right, this evening, Griffin High School Concert Band will be performing Night Chase by Chandler Wilson. Mr. Goodman.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, our meeting will be called to order by Crescent Elementary scholar Lily Grace Hoffman. All right. Lily is a scholar at Crescent Elementary. We met Lily through Mr. Adam Pugh, who is our Director of Communications, and Lily sent Mr. Pugh an email, and I want you to read that for us now, Lily Grace.
This is Lily Grace Hoffman, the winner of the Great Give and Shake. How is your day going? I want to talk to you about the billboards I've observed around downtown Griffin. I was in the car with my mom one day when I saw a billboard of the winner of the spelling bee with her trophy. That made me wonder, what do I need to do to get on that billboard? Well, I'm here today to discuss the reasons I think I worked hard enough to get on that billboard. 1, I learned from you to always go the extra mile. 2, eye contact is very important. 3, to always give a firm handshake. 4, to sit up straight and have good posture. 5, how to politely debate with people and not be disrespectful or rude. I was competing against 4th and 5th graders in the Great Griffin Shake from across 11 elementary schools. I won first place out of 68 students. You spoke with our class about never giving up and always giving the best we have. I believe that I worked hard enough and overcame many obstacles, both emotionally and mentally, to earn my place on that billboard. I appreciate your time. I know how busy you can get. Please consider letting me, the winner of the Great Griffin Shake, represent Griffin Spalding County Schools on one of the billboards in the county. Thank you for all you do for Griffin Spalding County Schools. Sincerely, Lily Grace Hoffman.
Let's give Lily a hand.
Thank you so much, Lily.
Yes, we have words from our dynamic superintendent, Dr. Keith Simmons.
Lily Grace, thank you. I'd like to make you a deal. If you will allow me to be on that billboard with you, I think I can allow you to be on the billboard. What do you think? Mr. Pugh?
Well, I think maybe we need to get you to climb up on the billboard because it's up in two places. That's it behind you. So maybe we could take you to El Toro Loco and take a picture of you on the billboard.
I'm afraid of heights. Never mind, Lily Grace. Go ahead. Congratulations.
Awesome job. Let's give her another round of applause. Thank you so much. You can take Mr. Dawson's hand. Mr. Holmes. All right, Lil Grace, on this side we have Mrs. Cook and Ms. McDonald. This is what it's all about, celebrating our scholars and showing that they definitely have what it takes to be great here in Griffin.
Woo! Absolutely.
All right. At this time, we'll have our prayer and pledge of allegiance. We're going to ask that fifth grader Nahavia Allen from Moore Elementary join us up front.
Before I give the invocation, can I have the church say amen?
Amen.
Oh, y'all can do better than that. Let the church say amen. I gave out programs, man. I thought we were going to have some church tonight. Amen. Before I go any further, I just got to make note that I am a proud graduate of Griffin High School, class of 1979. And I have to say, your principal and your assistant principal are representing the school quite well today. Come on now, give them a hand. Thank you all. Lord God, we come right now in no other way than we know how. That's with bowed heads and humbleness in our hearts. Father God, we pray, first of all, that your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Then, Father God, give us the guidance, the leadership, and the knowledge to be able to make decisions best for our scholars and all the constituents in our community. We ask, Father God, that you cover and bless these scholars, cover and bless the staff, and cover and bless everyone who is an auxiliary of our school system. And Father God, last but not least, we just want to thank you, Lord God, for another day and another opportunity. And it's in Jesus' name we do pray. Let every heart say amen.
My name is Nahavia Allen from Moore Elementary. Would you please stand for the pledge? I pledge of allegiance to the flag of United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, individual, and liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. Again, welcome to the Griffin Spalding County School Board of Education. Board meeting today is March 21st. Meeting is at 6 o'clock p.m. Item 3 on our agenda is the Griffin Spalding County School Spotlight, John Henry Moore Elementary. Let's give him a hand. John Henry Moore Elementary is a District 1 school, so I'll be happy to present our District 1 spotlight today from the board. How many scholars attend your school? There are 346 scholars at John Henry Moore Elementary School. What is your school mascot? Our mascot is the Bear Cub. How many faculty and staff members work at your school? We have 46 faculty and staff members. A quote from the principal on why you love being the proud principal of the school. At Moore, we relentlessly pursue academic excellence. I have a committed team of professionals who go the extra mile for kids every day. I have great kids and a supportive community who wants to see us succeed. What good things are going on at the school socially and educationally? One thing I am especially proud of is the way our school steps up to support our scholars, not just academically, but socially and emotionally as well. After the tornado, we had a team of staff supporting in the community. We hosted a clothing drive, served food, and checked in on the well-being of every scholar that we serve. One thing about Moore is we will rally together to support our families. What is the school doing? One way we remove barriers is to hold high expectations for every scholar who enters our building. We fully believe that all kids can and will learn at John Henry Moore Elementary. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, let's welcome the staff members, the faculty members, and any scholars that are here from John Henry Moore Elementary. Please come to the front. If you would, we'll join us over there in front of the Griffin Spalding display for our picture. All right, item number 4 on our agenda is the Griffin Spalding County School System announcements. Passing it over to the representative from the Sacred Second, Vice Chairman Will Doss.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. And I believe we have Maddie Murray with us this evening, possibly somewhere. Maddie can go ahead and be working your way up here to the podium. Maddie is a 12th grader at Spalding High School, and varsity soccer, Key Club, National Honor Society, National Technical Honor Society, FCCLA, and Georgia Merit Award. And probably the most exciting thing recently is Friday she found out that she is accepted to the University of Georgia.
Go Dawgs!
She is majoring in marketing, and on her college choices, she only had one on this list, so I'm glad they said yes to you. I think it's also important to know that our previous meeting that we had, Wilson Blaylock, is also going to be going to the University of Georgia with you. So
go Dawgs.
It's exciting to see what's happening with our scholars. If you would, present our announcements.
Chairman Brown, members of the board, and Superintendent Simmons, my name is Maddie Murray. I am a senior at Spalding High School. I would like to thank the Board of Education for involving scholars of the district in the policy and legislative process. The announcements for the March 21st, 2023 Board of Education meeting are as follows. GSCS District Reading Bowl, March 24th, 2023 at the GSCS Enrichment Center, 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. National Assistant Principals Week is April 3rd to 7th, 2023. April 3rd to 7th, 2023 is Griffin Spalding County School System Spring Break. April 4th, 2023 is School Librarian Appreciation Day. April 5th, 2023 is National Paraprofessional Appreciation Day. Tuesday, April 11th, 2023 is Griffin Spalding County Board of Education Board Meeting at 216 South 6th Street, Griffin, Georgia, 30223 at 6 p.m. Tuesday, April 24th, 2023 is Griffin Spalding County Board of Education Retreat. Governance team, cabinet members, and stakeholders, this concludes the Board of Education announcements for Tuesday, March 23rd, 2023. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you so much, Mr. Vice Chair. All right, next item. Item 5 is adoption of the agenda. What is the pleasure of this board?
Mr. Chair, I make a motion for the adoption of the agenda with one addition. Under presentations and discussions, number 2, if we would put an archway update.
Absolutely. You have heard from the Vice Chair to make the following change to the agenda. Under item number 11, presentation and discussions, it will be item number 2. What is the pleasure of this board?
Accept the Vice Chair's motion as presented with corrections.
Thank you so much. It has been properly motioned and seconded by Doss of the first and Leader Holmes of the third. When your name is called, please let me know your vote. Leader Holmes.
Yay.
Vice Chairman Doss.
Yes.
Ms. McDonald.
Yes.
Dean Cook.
Yes.
Brown. Yes. That is therefore passed 5-0. It is adopted. All right, now we have recognitions. Ms. Sue McDonald.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome, and thank you for being here tonight. Our recognitions include, to begin, Ms. Jenny Wilson, a fine arts music performance. Ms. Wilson?
Good evening again, Chairman Brown, Board of Education members, and Superintendent Simmons. Our second performance tonight will be by the Atkinson Singers. Mr. David Lackey is the music educator at Atkinson Elementary. He's been a music educator for 19 years, and 17 of those have been at Atkinson. The Atkinson Singers were founded in 2006. The Atkinson Singers consist in total of 60 third, fourth, and fifth graders. And this evening, the Atkinson Singers will be performing for us One Moment in Time by Dana Winner.
Let's give them a hand.
That is amazing. Let's give it up for our scholars one more time.
Chairman Brown, Board of Ed, and Dr. Simmons, thank you for the opportunity for our groups to perform. On the table, there was a green gift bag for you, and that's just a small token of appreciation from the fine arts programs here in Griffin Spalding County Schools. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Wilson. I think I just heard some American Idols or children that probably need to get on The Voice. I don't know about you guys, but I love reality TV because a lot of times they do the backgrounds of these kids that get on this TV, and some of them have been through horrific upbringings, and it fills my heart to know that they have survived and are able to get on American Idol or The Voice, because it's just very rewarding to hear those stories from those kids. So thank you again, Ms. Wilson. We appreciate everything you do for the Fine Arts Department. Next, we have our Griffin High School Lady Bears, the GHSA 4A Girl State Champion Basketball Team, Travis Smith.
Let's go!
Ladies, coaches, if y'all could go ahead and come up. Ladies, y'all come up front. While they're coming up, on behalf of our principal, Mr. Herbert Chambers, we want, first of all, say how proud we are of our band. They left before we could give them another congratulations. Going from 20-something members to 82 is a huge feat, and they ought to be commended for it. Mr. Chambers always preaches about arts, academics, and athletics, and we're striving and making strides in all three areas at Griffin High School. While they're getting situated, words can't express how proud we are of these young ladies. First, how proud we are of Griffin. If you weren't there, Griffin was in the Coliseum on March 8th.
Class of 2004.
So Griffin was definitely in the building, and these ladies didn't let us down. Just real quick before I give it over to Coach Johnson, I had several conversations with these young ladies last year. In their eyes, we underperformed last year. I think we lost elite in the Sweet 16, right? We had some things that weren't going right in the building, okay? We had several conversations in the lunchroom and pleading with them to lead our building. I let them know that they were the most successful program in our building, and if anyone deserved the right to hold the mantle for Griffin High School, it was them. And they took the challenge on head on this year. We made a change at the leadership, and we told them we were going to bring in a championship-level coach who were going to make sure they were champions in the building as well as on the court. And I think we were able to do that. These young ladies, if you're not aware, their team GPA is a 3.8, and every female in this program, I think we got about 30 young ladies. And all of them have a 3.0 GPA or higher. So that is to be commended. So while they definitely got it done on the court, they're taking care of business in the classroom as well, and we are definitely proud of them. With that being said, I'll turn it over to our head coach, Coach Roy Johnson.
Good afternoon. Thank you for the board and for you all coming out to honor these young ladies. First of all, it's not just me. Coach Willie Puckett and Coach Javora Thompson and also Coach Rail Robinson. They've been with me all year long and really have helped us groom these young ladies to be viable in our school building and also successful on the basketball court. What we're also proud about is we have six seniors. All six are going to college. We have Aaliyah Durham and Leah Turner are going to Mississippi Valley State together to play basketball. We also have Samia Puckett going to East Tennessee State to also play basketball. We also have Zai Thompson. She hasn't committed yet, but she has Central Arkansas, possibly UTSA, possibly Pensacola. She has many different opportunities as well to play basketball. And then we have Amy. Amy is our volleyball player plus our main cheerleader. But as a volleyball player, she will be going to Bruton Parker to play volleyball. And then my sixth senior, she's not here today, Raquariana Reed. She will also be going to school for academics or for volleyball. So that's what we're proud about. It's not only about basketball. It's also about them having opportunities outside of Griffin High School and Griffin Spalding counties. And it's on to the next level, our juniors, to also do the same thing. But we really want to thank you. We were so happy to see all that green in the stands. We really needed that, especially that late push. It was because of you all that got us over the hump. We appreciate it. As we said all year, this was for the G. We wanted to make sure that we left our mark on this school, because you go in that gym every day and you keep seeing the boys basketball, boys basketball, boys basketball, football here, football there. We said, well, what about the girls? Let's represent the ladies. And this was going to be the first time ever that we're going to have a big picture, and we already know what we wanted, a big, big old picture of the ladies program that's going to be on that wall. So again, thank you. We're so proud of them, and we appreciate everything you've done for us.
All right, board members, if we would join the Lady Bears for a picture over there.
Ladies, if you'll turn around and look on the screen, this billboard will be posted throughout Griffin. So make sure when we get it up, we'll let you know where it's posted so you guys can go and get pictures of it as well. Also, we are in the works for a parade to celebrate these young ladies. Details will be shared as they come along. All right, thank you guys.
Samia, Ms. Puckett, come here just a minute. I don't know if your teammates know this or not, but when I saw this on Twitter, I sent it to Mr. Brown. Samia,
full.
Samia is headed to my alma mater, East Tennessee State University. I grew up in Johnson City, Tennessee, and I just told her she will love Johnson City. It's nothing but like being in Asheville. It's just mountainous. I call it God's country because it's just so pretty. So the best of luck to you, and I'll be sure and let Coach Mock know that you are on your way from Griffin High School, and all the best to you as you enter ETSU this fall. Thank you. just
awesome, cool. Awesome, awesome. This is so exciting. Thank y'all so much. Thank you. All right. Okay. We have one more item. Griffin Spalding Board of Education coming from Dr. Keith Noop Simmons.
Hi.
All right, so really quickly, we'll let the young ladies leave, although we don't want the young ladies to leave. Please don't leave, young lady. I was just joking. So for those of you who are in the audience, for those of you who are viewing online, I just wanted to take a moment and acknowledge and say in the public how much I, as superintendent of school, enjoy being a part of this governance team, but most importantly, how much I appreciate the opportunity to work with you in service of all that these people have seen this evening, in service of our students and their education, in service of the opportunities that we strive to provide, in service of the empowerment and the betterment of the greater Griffin Spalding County community. So on behalf of the 10,000 students that we serve, the 14 to 1500 employees that we you know, support, and this entire community, thank you for your leadership, whether it be by day, whether it be by night, whether it be in private, whether it be in public. Do know from the bottom of my heart that I appreciate what you do, and most importantly, I appreciate why and for whom you do it. So having said that, I have some humble, simple certificates, and I'll start with you, Mr. Chair. Centel Brown, in appreciation and honoring you for continuing dedication and service to the Griffin Spalding County School System and to our community as a school board member. Now I have you, Mr. Doss. The language is the same. I would read it, but the audience is going to get mad at me, so I won't read it. Next up, you have Ms. Barbara Jo Cook. The sharpest dressed man in the building. I thought that was me, I'm sorry. Mr. Zachary Holmes. I understand, sir, I understand. And lastly, but certainly not least, Ms. Sue McDonald. Mr. Pugh, if you could get a group photo, I'd appreciate it.
Great.
Ms. McDonald, does that conclude your report?
I just wanted to publicly thank the parents and the students that came tonight to perform. I know after a long, hard work day, it's very difficult to do night activities sometimes, so I just wanted to acknowledge our parents and our staff members that came tonight also. We appreciate you more than you will ever know. Thank you very much. Mr. Brown?
All right. Thank you. All right, board members, we are at item 7, public comments. Mrs. Razor, anybody signed up? No. All right. Item number 8, we are going to allow you to leave and take a break for about 2 minutes.
Not long.
Maybe my keys will show up.
I know.
She's out in left field. Thank you.
So how did the meeting?
We both spoke. They voted 3-2 not to get back to the results. That's exactly what we did. So I think Zach and I being there made a difference.
All right, everybody, we are back at it again. Guess who's back? All right, item 9, the consent agenda. We see the items on the consent agenda listed on the agenda. In item 9, there's items 1, human resource personnel actions, item 2, business action items. What is the pleasure of this body?
Mr. Chair, I motion that we accept the consent agenda as presented.
Second.
It has been properly motioned by Leader Holmes of the Third and seconded by Mr. Doss of the Sacred Second. All those in favor, please vote by raising your right hand. And it passes 5-0. All right, next up, number 10, action items. T-Mobile Evergreen Service for Staff. Mr. Lonnie Harper. He's on double duty.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman, Board, Dr. Simmons. The district is asking the board to approve administrative cellular communication services to be transferred to T-Mobile for a monthly cost of $9,491.10 or $113,893.20 yearly. Quick background on this. We've always had Verizon service. One, the pandemic, when we were doing at-home learning, taught us that there were a lot of gaps with Verizon, and T-Mobile didn't have those gaps. We also have a number of schools like Rehoboth where we can't get Verizon signals in the building, but T-Mobile does cover that area. Griffin High, Spalding High, and Jordan Hill are not covered by either. And so T-Mobile has agreed to install boosters in those schools so that we can get signals in there. Also, they will be installing cradle point units, which would have been helpful during the recent tornadoes when administrators couldn't make calls out. But a cradle point will allow us to unplug the main office phone, plug it into the cradle point, and then that phone will operate off of cellular service. So we can still get calls and still make calls from the school phone. They'll also upgrading everyone to iPhone 14s, and all of that's still going to save us about $26,000 a year with all those additional services. So it is recommended that the board approves the transition of cellular service with T-Mobile for an annual cost of $113,893.20. Any questions?
Just want to be sure.
Hold on 1 second. Thank you so much, Mr. Harper, for your presentation.
Yes.
You've heard it. Are there any questions at this moment, board members?
Mr. Chair, yes.
All right, you're recognized.
Mr. Harper, I just want to be sure that the schools you mentioned, this equipment has been tested in those schools?
Yes, they sent us some demo phones, and we took them to all the locations. So Rehoboth, we had a call going on the way. We got out. We walked through the building and down the hallways. There was no service interruption. And we even did a few test calls out. We did the same thing at Jordan Hill. It worked in the lobby, but as soon as you turned into the office, to their conference room, calls were dropped. We tried again a couple of calls in different locations at Jordan Hill. And the same thing at the high schools. It was intermittent service unless you were near a window. So after talking with T-Mobile on that, they said, we have boosters. We'll come out and install one booster in the areas. And if it needs additionals, then especially the high schools being larger, They said they would install additional boosters to make sure the whole building area is covered.
Appreciate you doing this, because I know I visited Rehoboth right after the tornadoes, and that was on my list. Now I can mark it off, and Laura, we want everyone to be, you and everyone else that didn't have service that day after that tragedy. We are obviously want you all to be protected. So thank you, Mr. Harper.
You're welcome. All
right. Are there any other questions? All right, ladies and gentlemen, you've heard the report or the presentation from Mr. Harper. What's the pleasure of the board?
Move to accept.
It's been motioned to accept by Ms. McDonald and seconded by Leader Holmes. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. It's approved 5-0. Thank you. Next up, weapons detection system. Mr. Donald Bow Wow Wow Yippee Yo Brit.
I get it, Mr. Britt. I got it.
Good evening, Chairman Brown, board members, Dr. Simmons. The superintendent recommends that the Griffin Spalding County Board of Education approve the purchase of one single lane and one double lane weapons detection system to be placed at each high school location, not to exceed $500,000. Quick background, Griffin and Spalding High Schools currently utilize Garrett brand metal detection devices. The district wishes to move to the Evolve brand weapons detection system that will allow the free flow of traffic and detect weapons. The recommendation is, it is recommended that the Griffin Spalding County Board of Education approve the purchase of the Evolve weapons detection system for a price not to exceed $500,000 from Johnson Controls. The funding source for this would be general or ESSER III funds. Any questions?
All right, we have heard the report from Mr. Britt, Chief Britt. Are there any questions to this item?
No, I ain't gonna do it.
How many units will there be per school?
There will be two at Griffin High and two at Spalding High. There'll be one double lane each school and one single lane.
We saw this at the Georgia School Board Association meeting in December, and it was pretty impressive because it's software. To upgrade the equipment, you download software. Is that correct? That's the way it was explained to us, as I recall.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay. Mercedes-Benz uses it, yes. I think. Atlanta Braves use it.
Yes, Atlanta Braves, Atlanta Public Schools, Clayton Schools, different school systems.
Okay. Yeah, it's pretty impressive. Thank you.
All right. Are there any other questions to this agenda item? Right. What is the pleasure of this body as it relates to weapons detection system?
So moved.
Second.
It has been properly moved by the Dean of this board, Mrs. Barbara Jo Cook, and seconded by Leader Zachary Holmes of the 3rd District. All those in favor, please raise your right hand. 5-0, therefore passed. Thank you, Chief.
Thank you, Mr. Britt.
All right, next up. LED marquee signs, Mr. Byron Moneybag Yo Jones.
All right, here we go.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
You're welcome.
The superintendent recommends that the Griffin Spalding County Board of Education approve the purchase of 20 LED marquee signs to be placed at each school location, not to exceed $1 million. Just a quick background on this. This was a collaborative effort with Jordan Bullock from my office, who is our procurement specialist. Adam Pugh with Communications, Dr. Simmons, Deputy Superintendent Dr. Warren, and Bruce Ballard to collaborate on how to bring some synchronicity to our signage throughout the school district. And so we're happy to do this, and we will be using general funds for this. We're hoping that this will be completed in a 20 to 26 week cycle for all schools, and it will standardize signs to be the same look at all school locations. And again, there will be 20. Approximately 8 foot in height would be the length. 3.8 foot would be the height of the LED actual cabinet itself, backlit procedure, and then 2 foot above that would be the school ID panel, which would be specific to the school for their mascot or their logo, etc. So with that being said, it's recommended that the Griffin Spalding County Board of Education approve the purchase of the requested LED marquee signs for a price not to exceed $1 million from Daktronics. Marquee signage would be purchased using general funds. Are there any questions?
All right, thank you so much, Mr. Jones. We have heard his presentation. Are there any questions at this time?
Just Mr. Chair.
You are recognized, Ms. McDonald.
Thank you. Will the district office also, I may have missed it, will the district office also have one, a new one?
Not yet. Let me answer that. I've been on that for a while.
I yield to Mr. Holmes.
Not yet. We're doing some renovation on the campus with the parking, and once we get that done, then we're going to have a sign up. That, did I do good, Superintendent?
Yes, sir. So Ms. McDonald, as you know, we've talked about some continued renovation for the Taylor Street campus that will include the front-facing portion of what's now the Parent Resource Center facing 16. Mm-hmm. When we complete that renovation to include more parking in the front, we will place a larger LED marquee that is designed to handle the thoroughfare of traffic on 16, but also communicate announcements regarding various schools as well as the district office. So what Mr. Holmes was saying is we will get one here at district office. It probably won't come with the installation at the schools because of the renovation, but gotcha. Mr. Ballard's gonna get us an update when we get the update regarding the Taylor Street renovations.
Thank you.
Chairman Brown, I have a question, please.
Leader Holmes, you're recognized.
Mr. Jones, I was just curious because of sometime we have to get messages out in a timely manner. Will there be a central control location attached to this where we could post messages simultaneously at all the schools without each individual school having to do it themselves?
It's my understanding that the school-specific personnel will have the ability to do their own signage on site. But if communication superintendent wants to push out a centralized message, they will have the ability to do that with this technology. Is that correct, Superintendent?
Mr. Chair.
Go ahead, sir.
Yes, sir, Mr. Jones, that is correct. Another added feature, Mr. Holmes, is that in the event that we had inclement weather, we at central office, Norwood school leaders have to come to the school to get those messages communicated on the marquees. That was one of the specs or the features having the wireless capability. So that centralized communication hub is actually anywhere where you have internet access. Those who have administrative rights have the ability to push communications to their respective, marquees at the school, as would we here at central office. So we're excited about the opportunity to improve communication proper, but also improve the efficiency. No sense in having school leaders come into school in inclement weather to say on the marquee there's inclement weather. We'll be able to do that from home and still get the community informed the way that we're desired to do so.
Just make sure you put information like that on Facebook, too.
Yes, sir. Will do. That's Mr. Pugh.
Thank you. Are there any other questions for this item? All right, here none. We've heard the report from Mr. Jones. What is the pleasure of this board?
I motion, Mr. Chair, that we approve as presented by Mr. Jones with the specs and staying within the limitations.
Thank you so much.
Second.
All right, it has been properly motioned by Leader Holmes of the Third and seconded by Vice Chairman Doss of the Sacred Second. At this time, please raise your hand to vote yes. 5-0, therefore passed.
All right, from the peanut gallery.
Hallelujah.
All right, next up, item number 11, presentation and discussion. Our February 2023 monthly financial report, Mr. Byron Jones.
I'm wondering, can I get that kind of clap when I'm done with this? Well, thank you, Mr. Chairman, board members again. This is our February 28th board financial report. So this is 8 months through the fiscal year, and we usually talk about the balance sheet. A high of the year of approximately $46.5 million on your left bottom yellow item for the general fund. Again, that will begin to decrease a little bit because the majority of our taxes are collected in the month of January, this prior tax collection cycle. And then over to the right, the nutrition program continues to be very strong in its fund balance of $2.7 million through the month of February. Page number two, again, is our grants, is our general fund. Our left-hand current month, $5.3 million in revenue with $7.2 million in expenses. Again, that will be the trend for the rest of the time through this fiscal year. That still leaves us at a cumulative $10.6 million to the good with revenues higher than expenses so far through this fiscal year. Page three is our special revenue grant funds. I think I mentioned this last month, most of those Department of Education grants have been approved now, so our revenues have come in higher. We don't have such a difference in revenue and expense as we had in the prior few months. Page four is the actual nutrition financial statement through February. $5.2 million in revenue and $4.3 million in expense, with an overall a little over $900,000 to the good for an nutrition program. Again, with that community eligibility provision, program is still being very strong for our school district. Page five is our investment register, approximately $31.4 million. Again, is what we have invested, and these are our SPLOST accounts and other investments that we hold as a fiduciary here for the school district. And our last page is through the month of January, still $1 million, collection, a little over $1 million in the month of January for eSPLOST collections. And I will remind you, the gas tax is back now. You know, it was suspended for a long time, but it is back. And also in the month of January, you know, with our tornado, it'll be interesting to see how that transpires if we drop any over the next few months, just in people's habits and shopping, et cetera. So January is kind of a little weird month, two or three different things going on, but we're still over $1 million, even with that being said. So any questions?
All right, we've heard the presentation. Now we're ready for discussion. Are there any questions to item one?
No, sir.
All right, hearing none, thank you so much.
Yay!
All right, this time we will have an archway update from Vice Chairman Will Doss, representing the Sacred Second. Mr. Vice Chairman.
Thank you for that opportunity. In front of you, you should have one of these colored brochures. It's just a front and back. This time each year, we're beginning the conversation about Archway. Most of you know we are an Archway community. Both our city, county, and school system are putting in $20,000 each, and then it is being matched by Archway. The reason those figures are important is because that $120,000 has been leveraged for our return on investment, to that $277,130 figure that is on that piece of paper. Our city and county have just gone through the lost process again for a 10-year plan. Wasn't without a few hiccups, but we have come through that. The idea is that Archway has been helpful in our communication, and they want to continue doing Archway. So took some talking, took some figuring. We have been an Archway community for about 8 years, and Chuck Copeland and Stephanie Windham have been the leaders of that, along with the executive committee. And so some of the changes and things that will be taking place, I think they are ready to possibly step down and take a break. So there'll be some additional leadership that'll come in from that executive committee. There will be a relook at what our priorities are. If you look on that back page, the priority areas, there's three that are listed there. So we're gonna see how, make sure those are still relevant. We have our superintendent, myself, and our chairman that sits on that executive committee. And so we will continue that process. In April, the MOUs will be coming down again for the next fiscal year. So that will be brought before us probably at our next meeting to be able to approve those expenditures. So any questions that I might could answer?
Before we do questions, our superintendent is going to ask you to clarify something before we go into questions from the board.
Sure.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Doss, for those who may be in the audience or online and may not be familiar with the LOST and that process, can you give them a little bit more insight, please?
Sure. Every 10 years, our community the LOST is the local option sales tax, not eSPLOST or SPLOST, but that is just that local option sales tax. And so the services that are provided to our community, where they overlap between city and county, those things have to be divvied up and decided upon the dollars and the amounts that go that way. And so that process happens every 10 years. It's actually something that not every community deals with it, but can cause divisiveness within communities because of the difficulties that comes with that. There's not ever enough dollars to go around, and so that process is tough.
Thank you. Are there any board members who have a question about this or want to make a comment about Arts Way? Leader Holmes?
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
You're welcome.
To Mr. Dawson, Dr. Simmons, and Mr. Brown, I make it no secret that this is not one of my favorite things to participate in, because I have been around since the inception of Archway, and I still, even though we've committed some projects, completed some projects, I still feel that we're just scratching the surface. And one thing that I would ask whomever represents the school board, I take you back to the first meeting that we had at the Senior Center, Citizen Center. We had the director of Chamber of Commerce from Henry County. I don't know if Mr. Doss was present, but I can't remember anyone else. But she spoke to the three governmental entities and concerned citizens. And this has always been at the forefront of my thinking of how we were going to attack things in our community through Archway. And I see the priority areas listed on this this handout, but I remind you, and I think it needs to stay in the forefront, that this lady, I can't remember her name, she told us how they became so successful over in Henry County. They identified one area that they all, city, county, school system, were going to focus on. And that one area was, guess what? Education. And I do not feel by the transpiring of events and things that go on that we have collaborated to focus on one area that we can all pool money, not just talk, but pool money, resources into making a difference. Until I see that we have leaders who are not shooting down the school system publicly, and but supporting the school system, I would not be on board with what we spend money on to be a part of Archway. If we really want to make a difference through Archway, we would all commit ourselves, and not saying that I want everything to go toward education, but it has been proven, has been tried, has been tested, that if you have a good education system, your community will increase. That's been proven, that's been shown, but I cannot keep supporting this Archway when we are not walking the talk. And I've said this, and I don't bite my tongue now. I've said it publicly. All we do is meet, go on retreats, talk about stuff, and then when we come back, it's back to your own silos, doing what you do, and no one is really collaborating. We should not have had to go to the county commissioners meeting to speak that what they were contemplating, even thinking about doing. It should have never been a thought. They should have never entertained taking money out of the school system. So I cannot keep, I'm not going to put up a front and say that I'm all in on Archway. I'm not, because I have not seen the true work that we were supposed to dedicate ourselves to do with the onset of Archway coming into our community. Until I see that change and see the city, county, and school system really collaborating, seeing them put money into the coffer of whatever project we choose, it's really just a bunch of talk to me, and we just scratching the surface. We've been in conception 8 years, and we $277,000.
No, that is for this year.
That's for this year?
Yes, sir.
That's what I'm saying.
An average of that each year.
Average is that each year. Do you think that's adequate?
for the return on investment?
Yes.
I think it's pretty good.
Well, I have to disagree, Mr. Dawes, because if it was, I don't think that